الحمد لله، الحمد لله لا عز إلا بطاعته ولا سعادة إلا بتقواه. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، لا رب لنا سواه، ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله ومصطفاه وخليله ومجتباه. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه بإحسانٍ إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى، فلا سعادة ولا فوز ولا نجاة إلا باتباع هداه. قال تبارك وتعالى: من عمل صالحاً من ذكرٍ أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون. أيها الأحبة، في أحد المستشفيات كان هناك مريضان في غرفة واحدة. There was in a hospital two sick people. كلاهما مصاب بمرض عضال. And each one of them was sick with a terminal illness. أحدهما كان مسموح له بالجلوس في سريره لمدة ساعة يوميا بعد العصر. One of them was allowed to sit up after عصر just for 1 hour. أما الآخر فكان مجبرا على التمدد طيلة أيامه. As for the other one who was very sick, he had to stay on his back all the time. He could not sit up. ولحسن حظ المسموح له بالجلوس فقد كان سريره بجانب النافذة الوحيدة في الغرفة. The one who was able to sit up for 1 hour only per day, he was lucky because his bed was next to the only window in the room. So two very sick people lying on their back, one of them only was able to sit up and his bed was next to the window, he used to look outside. وكان المريضان يقضيان وقتهما في الكلام دون أن يرى أحدهما الآخر. And they both used to speak to each other, but without looking at each other. لأن كلاهما كان مستلقيا على ظهره ناظرا إلى السقف. Because both were on their back looking at the ceiling. وفي كل يوم العصر أو بعد العصر كان الأول يجلس في سريره كما أمر الطبيب. فينظر في النافذة واصفا لصاحبه العالم الخارجي، وكان الآخر ينتظر هذه الساعة كما ينتظرها الأول. Every day, the one who was looking outside the window, he would describe to the other person what he was seeing outside. And they would both wait for this hour every day. لأنها تجعل حياته مفعمة بالحيوية وهو يستمع لوصف صاحبه للحياة بالخارج. And they used to be very excited. The whole day wait for this hour because one was explaining to the other what he was seeing outside. فكان الرجل ليقول لصاحبه عن الحديقة الخارج من النافذة: هناك بحيرة كبيرة يسبح فيها البط والأولاد قد صنعوا زوارق من مواد مختلفة وأخذوا يلعبون إلى آخره. والجميع يتمشى حول حافة البحيرة وآخرون يجلسون في ظلال الأشجار وبجانب الزهور. وفيما يقوم الأول بعملية الوصف ينصت الآخر في ذهول لهذا الوصف الدقيق الرائع. The one who was looking outside the window every day, he was describing to the other person, there is a beautiful garden outside, there is a pond, there are people walking, there are trees, there are roses, people, husband and wife walking near the pond, young children playing and laughing. Beautiful description. And the other one's listening all the time. ثم يغمض عينيه ويبدأ في تصور هذا المنظر البديع للحياة خارج المستشفى. And the other one who could not see outside would then imagine and become full of hope and joy, imagining the beauty outside. ومرت الأيام والأسابيع وكل منهما سعيد لصاحبه. Days and months and weeks pass and they both are happy with each other. Though they can't see each other, And the one can see what's outside, but he's imagining. وفي أحد الأيام جاءت الممرضة صباحا لخدمتهما كعادتها فوجدت المريض الذي بجانب النافذة قد مات. When the nurse one day came to check on them, she saw the one who was near the window had passed away. ولم يعلم الآخر بوفاته إلا من خلال حديث الممرضة عبر الهاتف. And the other one did not know that his friend died except when the nurse was speaking on the phone asking for help to come and take the dead body. فحزن على صاحبه أشد الحزن. So he became very sad when his friend died, who used to explain to him what was outside. وعندما وجد الفرصة مناسبة طلب من الممرضة أن تنقل سريره إلى جانب النافذة. When they moved the dead body, he asked the nurse after some time, could you please now move my bed so it's near the window? Because my friend died and he can't tell me what's outside, I want to see. So move my bed next to the window. ولما حانت ساعة العصر تذكر الحديث الشيق الذي كان يتحفه به صاحبه وطلب من الطبيب أن يسمح له بأن ينهض مرة واحدة كل يوم لينظر من النافذة فوافق. عندما جاءت الساعة تحامل على نفسه وهو يتألم ورفع رأسه رويدا رويدا مستعينا بذراعيه ثم اتكى على أحد رفقيه وأدار وجهه ببطء تجاه النافذة لينظر إلى العالم الجميل الخارج. وهنا كانت المفاجأة. When they put him near the window and he asked to be lifted to see, look outside, with lots of difficulty, he was in pain. He wants to see the beautiful world outside which his friend described to him. And then there was a surprise. حيث لم يرى أمامه إلا جداراً أصماً من جدران المستشفى. He could not see outside except one big wall. فقد كانت النافذة على ساحة داخلية. Because the window wasn't looking into a garden, it was looking inside the hospital, but there is a big wall. نادى الممرضة وسألها إن كانت هذه هي النافذة التي كان صاحبه ينظر من خلالها. So he called the nurse and he said, is this the same window that my friend was next to? She said, it is the only window. إن الغرفة ليس لها سوى هذه النافذة. She says, there is no other window but this window. This is the window he used to sit by. ثم سألته عن سبب تعجبه. And she asked him, why are you surprised that this is the only window? فقص عليها ما كان يرى صاحبه عبر النافذة وما كان يصفه له. كأن تعجب فكان تعجب الممرضة أكبر. He described to her what his friend used to tell him. And now there is nothing. So the nurse was even more amazed, more surprised. إذ قالت له, she said to him, ولكن المتوفى كان أعمى. She said, the man who died, he was blind. ولم يكن يرى حتى هذا الجدار الأصم. He couldn't even see the wall. So what was he describing to you? ثم قالت له, لكنه كان يكون فعل ذلك ليجعل حياتك سعيدة وحتى لا تصاب بالبأس فتتمنى الموت. He said, but I think he used to tell you this so to make your life happy and so that you don't wish to die. أيها الأحبة, هناك صنف من الناس يرون أن أعظم مقامات العبادة أن يكونوا مفاتيح للأمل والسعادة. سعادتهم أن يروا الناس سعداء وحياتهم في المساعدة والخير والعطاء يواسون الناس بجاههم ومالهم وابتساماتهم وتسمع التفاؤل والأمل والحب في كلماتهم. يفرحون إذا رأوا ابتسامة المحزونين ويسعدون إذا سمعوا رجاء البائسين. يفعلون ذلك رغبة وحبا وسرورا لله تعالى حتى ولو وجدوا من الناس صدا وإعراضا وشرورا. وشعارهم إنما نسعد الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا. وتأملوا في حال الأنبياء أيها الأحبة مع أقوامهم وما يجدونه منهم من الأذى والاستهزاء، وهم يريدون لهم السعادة في الدنيا وفي دار البقاء، ولسان حالهم: وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يمتعكم متاعا حسنا إلى أجل مسمى ويؤتِ كل ذي فضل فضله، وإن تولوا فإني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم كبير. Why the story? Because there are some people, there are two types of people. There are some people who want to bring nothing but misery and difficulties and frowning and sadness and sorrow on anybody else. They can't seem to find happiness in life. They don't want others to be happy. But there are other people, and this is the quality of the mu'mineen. This is the quality of the believers, and this is the essence of the story. How can you bring happiness to the lives of others? There are people who love to see others smile. They want to see others smile. When they go to their houses, there are some people who, when they go to their own houses, they bring nakal, misery to their houses. They go to their houses frowning, upset, angry, hard. They think this is deen. This is deen. My brothers, a mu'min is a person of hopefulness. بَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا وَيَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, he says, بَشِّرُوا, give glad tidings. وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا, and don't repel people. You know, there are some human beings, they are like mosquito repellent. The minute you come close to them, you just want to run away. There are some people who attract you through their smile, their beauty, their good heart. That is how we should be. Yes, there are difficulties in life. Yes, the ummah is going through difficulties, but our amal is in Allah. Our hope is in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Look at the lives of the Anbiya. The Prophets, no matter how much difficulties they went through, no matter how much hardships the people gave them, they always wished good for people. وَإِنْ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. They gave them difficulties, their hardship, and they used to say to them, please, just seek Allah's forgiveness, make tawbah, and Allah will forgive you. Allah will give you goodness in this world. Allah will give you goodness in the akhirah. This was their position. وَاسْمَعُوا إِلَى هَذَا الْمَوْقِفِ والمسلمون في قمة البلاء كيف يبقى مفتاح الأمل والسعادة بيد الأنبياء. And listen to this story. When the Muslims were at the worst of their time, they were suffering tremendously. But the Prophets عليه الصلاة والسلام always infused, always breathed a sign of hopefulness in the lives of their people. في غزوة الخندق عندما قدمت قريش وحاصرت المدينة بعشرة آلاف مقاتل، والقصة معروفة. في موقف رهيب كما وصفه الله تبارك وتعالى: إذ جاءوكم من فوقكم ومن أسفل منكم وإذ زاغت الأبصار وبلغت القلوب الحناجر. It was during the battle of the Khandaq, the trench. The situation was so difficult on Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Sahaba that Allah describes the situation. When they came from above you, meaning the enemies, 10,000 of them, 10,000 from above you, from under you, and when you could not, your vision became blurred, and when your souls reach your throats, this is the situation. وَكَانَ حَالُ أَهْلِ الْإِيمَانِ. But the condition of the people of Iman in this most difficult time, كَمَا قَالَهُ سُبْحَانَهُ هُنَالِكَ أُبْتُلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَزُلْزِلُوا زِلْزَالًا شَدِيدًا. Allah describes the situation of the believers. They were tested, the most difficult test, and they were shaken. فَفِي تِلْكَ اللَّحْظَةِ أَمَرَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بِحَفْرِ الْخَنْدَقِ لِتَحْصِيلِ الْمَدِينَةِ فعرضت لهم صخرة لا تأخذ فيها المعامل فاشتكوا ذلك إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشوفوا الأمل. In this difficult situation, he said, go and dig it. Let's dig a trench. And they began to dig a trench. And as they were digging a trench, there was a massive rock that came their way to make matters more difficult. There was a massive rock. But look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at his tafawur, look at his optimism, look at his hope in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They went and complained to him, Ya Rasulullah, there is a big rock, we can't even break it. We can't break it. فَاشْتَكَوْنَا فَجَاءَ فَأَخَذَ الْمِعْوَلُ وَقَالَ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ He took the axe and he said, بِسْمِ اللَّهِ فَضَرَبَ ضَرَّةً فَكَسَرَ ثُلُثَهَا He struck the rock with one strike and a third of it was broken. And he said, اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ أُعْطِيتُ مَفَاتِيحَ الشَّامِ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأُبْصِرُ قُصُورَهَا الْحُمْرَ السَّاعَةِ Look at the difficult situation, difficult moment, 10,000 people about to attack him. He strikes the rock and he says, اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ I can see with my own eyes the palaces, the red palaces of Sham. I have been given the keys of Sham. الله أكبر ثم ضرب الثاني فقطع الثلث الثاني then he struck it a second time and the third part, the second third of the rock destroyed ثم قال الله أكبر then he says الله أكبر أعطيت مفاتيح فارس I have been given the keys to Persia والله إني لأبصر قصر المدائن الأبيض he says I can see the palaces of Persia ثم ضرب الثالث وقال بسم الله then he struck it a third time and he said بسم الله الله أكبر أعطيت مفاتيح اليمن والله إني لا أبصر أبواب صنعاء من مكان هذا الساعة he says I have been given the keys of Yemen and I can see its palaces and houses meaning he was giving them glad tidings yes the situation is difficult yes there are 10,000 people about to pounce on you But never forget Allah تبارك وتعالى. وهكذا إخوتي في الله أتباع الأنبياء في العلم والعبادة لهم دور عظيم في نشر الأمل والسعادة. Yes, equally my brothers, especially the learned and the scholars and those who have some علم of deen and the Muslims, the mu'mins, we all have a role to spread happiness and to spread hope in the ummah. فها هو مؤمن آل فرعون وهو ينصح لقومه بكلمات الصدق والإخلاص التي خلدها الله تعالى في كتابه إلى يوم القيامة فيقول أتقتلون رجلا أن يقول ربي الله وقد جاءكم بالبينات من ربكم يا قومي لكم He said that the people, one of the people of Fir'aun, the believing man of Fir'aun, who hid his iman during the time of Fir'aun, And the situation was extremely difficult. And then he says to his people, you are killing a person who says Allah is my Lord. And then he gives them glad tidings. He gives them glad tidings. وَيَا قَوْمِ مَا لِي أَدْعُوكُمْ إِلَى النَّجَاةِ وَتَدْعُونَنِي إِلَى النَّارِ And then he said to them, why are you inviting me to destruction and I'm inviting you to happiness? I'm inviting them to pleasure in the hereafter. نعم أيها الأحبة وكما قال الشاعر أنا مسلم أسعى لإنقاذ الورى للنور للإيمان للإسعاد Yes, my brothers, a mu'min should always try to bring hope in the lives of others, especially our young brothers in a country like Australia who are going through so many difficulties. Our deen is a deen of hope. Our deen is a deen of optimism. Our deen is a deen of tafa'ul, not tasha'ul. It is a deen of optimism, not pessimism. That is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even taught us that if you see a bad dream, don't talk about it. Why? Because when you see a nightmare and you speak to people about it, it spreads pessimism, it spreads hopelessness. But he said if you see a good ru'ya, speak to the people you trust. If you see a good ru'ya, a good vision, speak about it. Why? Because you can spread optimism. You can put a smile on the faces of people. People are going through difficulties, hardships, whether it's with their work or their families or the situation back in their countries. The last thing we want to do is make it more miserable for people. Let's connect people with Allah. Bring a happiness on their faces. Let them realize that Allah Azza wa Jal is in control and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala can change worse situations to better situations. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم يا فوز المستغفرين استغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. نعم أيها الأحبة، كن أخي في الله مفتاح أمل وسعادة واطمئنان. My brother and my sister, be a person who is a key, somebody who spreads hope and happiness tranquility in the lives of people. فالصدور يكفي ما فيها من الهموم والأحزان. Because people, everybody is having suffering, everybody is going through difficulties. And the worst thing is, when somebody comes to speak to you about their issues, give them a hearing, listen to them. Don't judge, listen, and try to provide the best nasiha. فلا تزيد هم الناس هما. Don't increase people's worries with more worries. ولا تضعف غمهم غما. And don't increase their misery. بل كن كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام وهو الصادق المصدوق، أحب الناس إلى الله أنفعهم للناس، وأحب الأعمال إلى الله عز وجل سرور يدخله على المسلم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, the most beloved people, the most beloved to Allah are those who are most useful to people. The more useful you are to others, the more beloved you are to Allah. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلُّ سُرُورٌ يُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى مُسْلِمٍ. And the most beloved, listen to this carefully, the most beloved good deed is happiness that you bring to the life of a Muslim. أَوْ يَكْشِفُ عَنْهُ كُرْبًا أَوْ يَقْضِي عَنْهُ دَيْنًا أَوْ تَطْرُدُ عَنْهُ جُوعًا ولا أن أمشي مع أخ لي في حاجة أحب إلي من أن أعتكف في هذا المسجد، يعني مسجد المدينة شهرا، ومن مشى مع أخيه في حاجة حتى تتهيأ له أثبت الله قدمه يوم تزول الأقدام، أو ثبت الله قدمه يوم تزول الأقدام. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the best deed you can do is to bring happiness in the life of a Muslim, or to remove their hardships or difficulties, or to pay their debt, or to fulfill their hunger. And then he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to go with my brother and fulfill his need is better for me than making i'tikaf 1 month in my masjid. And the one who helps his brother or sister, Allah subhanahu until they fulfill their concern, then Allah Ta'ala will give them firmness on the day of Qiyamah when everybody will be shaken on that day. Yes, my brothers and sisters, a mu'min is a person, you know, Rasulullah said, always had a smile on his face, despite all the challenges, always. When he went inside his house, he went with a smile, always. He would be walking down the street and somebody would come and want to talk to him, he would stop. He would always try to infuse optimism in the lives of people. وَأَفْضَلُ النَّاسِ مَا بَيْنَ الْوَرَى رَجُلٌ تُقْضَى عَلَى يَدِهِ لِلنَّاسِ حَاجَاتٌ. And the best person is one who Allah uses to fulfill the needs of other people. لَا تَمْنَعَنَّ يَدَ الْمَعْرُوفِ عَنْ أَحَدٍ مَا دُمْتَ مُقْتَدِرًا فَالسَّعْدُ تَارَاتٌ. And he says, whenever you are able to help others, help. Don't hold back. Allah has given us so much in this country. What we have is what most people don't have. Help, whether they are Muslim or non-Muslim. وَاشْكُرْ فَضَائِلَ صُنْعِ اللَّهِ إِذَا جَعَلْتَ إِلَيْكَ لَا لَكَ عِنْدَ النَّاسِ فِي حَاجَاتِ. And thank Allah for the bounty that He has given you. Especially thank Him if He uses you to help fulfill the needs of others. قَدْ مَاتَ قَوْمٌ وَمَا مَاتَتْ مَكَارِمُهُمْ وَعَاشَ قَوْمٌ وَهُمْ فِي النَّاسِ أَمْوَاتُ. And there are people who left this dunya, they are dead, But their generosity and their kindness and helpfulness continue to be alive. They are dead, but their deeds are alive. People speak about them. And there are so many people who are alive, walking on the face of this earth in their physical bodies, but they are dead because they don't contribute to society, and especially they don't contribute to lift their communities and their societies when they are most in need. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us the means of goodness, and may Allah Azza wa Jal make us the means of hope and hopefulness, and may Allah Azza wa Jal use us to serve His deen and to serve everybody in need. هذا عباد الله صلوا وسلموا على رسول الله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم استخدمنا لخدمة دينك ولا تستبدلنا. اللهم استخدمنا ولا تستبدلنا. اللهم استخدمنا لخدمة دينك ولا تستبدلنا. اللهم كن معنا ولا تكن علينا. اللهم اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العز الأكرم. Brothers and sisters, there is an annual da'wah and اجتماع that will take place this Saturday at Wandana Masjid. It is tomorrow at Wandana Masjid from Maghrib Saturday, from Maghrib of Saturday till Fajr of Sunday. Everyone is welcome to join for the iftar, for the talks, sorry, after Maghrib, and talks after Isha, and talks after Fajr at Wandana. There is also dinner provided tomorrow at 7 p.m. at Wandana Masjid. All the brothers are welcome to attend and join. Jazakallah khair.